हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू जूलॉजी कॉन्सेप्ट्स। सो दिस इज़ द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द ऑप्टिकल मिनरोलॉजी सीरीज एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो दिस वीडियो विल बी ऑन हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू पोलराइज द लाइट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू सजेस्ट दैट बिफोर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो यू शुड वॉच द फर्स्ट एंड द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस सीरीज फॉर अ बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ दिस वीडियो। ओके, सो एज यू नो द पोलराइज लाइट वेव्स are the waves in which the vibration occurs in a single plane. So how are we going to do that? So the first method is through a Polaroid. Okay. So what is a Polaroid? A Polaroid is a type of synthetic plastic sheet used to polarize the light. Okay. So the first Polaroid was made from the crystals of a compound called herapathite. Okay. Herapathite. Or chemically you can say iodoquinone sulfate. Okay, and recently polyvinyl alcohol. Polyvinyl alcohol. Okay, written as PVA is used for this purpose. Okay, so what happens is that during the manufacture of the Polaroid, the crystals of herapathite or the PVA polymer chain are stressed and aligned in a linear fashion. So, like suppose this is the Polaroid and the crystals are aligned like this, like in this linear fashion, or the polymer chain of this polyvinyl alcohol is aligned in this fashion. Okay, or it can be any fashion, like, but it will be aligned in a linear fashion. So this way, when the light ray passes through the Polaroid, the ray vibrating parallel to the crystal alignment makes the electron vibrate and move along that direction and in turn absorb the light ray. Okay, but if the light ray passes perpendicularly to the alignment of the crystals or the polymer chain, the electrons cannot move along that direction and the light ray is not absorbed and allowed to pass through. So you can see here that as this unpolarized light, okay, this is an unpolarized light, passes through the Polaroid, they are polarized in a particular plane. Like this blue ray is polarized in a vertical direction, okay, and this red wave is polarized in a horizontal direction, like this one, okay, and vertically like this one. So if this polarizer is polarizing the light, like this polarizer is polarizing the light in this vertical direction, the crystals must be arranged perpendicular to it, right? Like this. Okay, they must be arranged in this direction, as the electrons can vibrate in this direction only and absorb the light coming parallel to it. Okay, like the electrons can vibrate in this direction only, so they will absorb the energy of the light which is coming parallel to it. So this way the light is being polarized with a Polaroid. Okay, so these Polaroids can be used, of course, in optical microscope. It can be used in sunglasses, cameras, etc. So the second method is by a Nicole prism. Okay, the technique used here is eliminating the O ray or the ordinary ray by total internal reflection. If a light ray passes from a denser medium to a rarer medium, it goes away from the normal. Okay, so if we if we continuously increase the incident angle, this is the incident angle and this is the angle of refraction. So if we increase the incident angle, the angle of refraction will also increase, and at a particular angle, at a particular incident angle, this refracted ray will be or the angle of refraction will be 90 degrees. Okay, so this angle of incidence is called IC, that is the critical angle of incidence. If the angle of incidence is increased further, the refracted ray will move
in the same medium and will be completely reflected. Okay, no light will be refracted. So this is the technique which is used here. And let's see now, what is an Nicol prism? So it is a rhombohedral crystal of Iceland spar. Okay, Iceland spar is a variety of calcite. And this rhombohedral crystal of Iceland spar is cut at 68 degrees with the crystal axis. Okay, you can see here the 68 degrees, and actually it is a 3D rhombohedral crystal. Okay, but it is shown only showing the plane along which these two rays are traveling. Okay, but this is actually a 3D crystal. Okay, so this crystal is cut diagonally. Okay, like along this line. Along this line, this crystal is cut and it is rejoined again using a layer of Canada balsam. Okay, a Canada balsam is a type of a resin. Okay, used for mounting the thin section. Okay, used as a glue. Okay, so let's see what will happen here. Okay, so you all know that calcite is an anisotropic crystal. Okay, as the light passes through a calcite crystal, it is split into two rays. That is, it will suffer double refraction. So the two rays will be ordinary and extraordinary. The ordinary ray here will suffer a refractive index of 1.658, and the extraordinary ray will suffer a refractive index of 1.486, and the refractive index of Canada balsam is 1.55. So what is happening here is that as the light enters the this Iceland spar, it is divided into two rays. Like, one is ordinary and one is extraordinary. The ordinary ray is traveling in this calcite with the refractive index of 1.658. Okay, so when it will travel straight in its path, it will somewhere encounter this Canada balsam layer where we joined these two crystals which were diagonally cut. As it passes into the Canada balsam, the refractive index it will suffer now is 1.55, right? This means that the ordinary ray is traveling from a denser medium to a rarer medium, like this case, which was the condition for the total internal reflection. Okay, the condition will be that if the incident ray is more than the critical angle. Okay, so here what is done, that this Iceland spar or this Nicol prism is positioned in such a way that the O ray will strike the Canada balsam at an angle which is greater than the critical angle. Okay, it will always strike it at an angle which will be greater than the critical angle. So it will suffer total internal reflection and it will be eliminated from the sides of this Nicol prism. But the extraordinary ray will suffer a refractive index of 1.486, and as it will come to the Canada balsam, it will have a refractive index of 1.55. Okay, so this means that the extraordinary ray is traveling from a rarer medium to a denser medium, right? So if the light passes from a rarer medium to a denser medium, no total internal reflection can take place. Okay, it cannot occur. So the extraordinary ray passes, simply it is refracted and it exits the Nicol prism from the upper surface and goes to the thin section. So you can see here that this was the unpolarized light which passed through this Nicol prism, and it is divided into two rays. Both are vibrating perpendicular to each other and in a single plane. So as the O ray is eliminated, there is only E ray left, which is vibrating in a particular plane, in a single plane. This means that the ray is polarized. So the third and the final method is reflection from a polished surface. Okay, so polished is a plane and a smooth surface. Okay, so we know that if a light is incident on a surface, okay, it is reflected and refracted both. Okay, both the phenomena are operating simultaneously. Okay, so if an unpolarized light is incident on a surface, like the surface, this polished surface, at this particular angle, which is the Brewster's angle. Okay, Brewster was the scientist who observed this phenomenon. Okay, so at this particular angle, what happens is that the reflected ray and the refracted ray make an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, so when this happens at this particular point, it is observed that the reflected ray is completely polarized. Okay, you can see the vibration direction is along a particular plane, a single plane, which is in and out of this screen. Okay, and the refracted ray is partially polarized. Okay, some of the vibration direction is present, some of both the vibration directions is present. So suppose if we now send a light which is vibrating in this plane of incidence, okay, this plane, okay, this is the plane of incidence, and it is polarized in this direction, and as it is incident on the surface, this polished surface, there was no light which was vibrating parallel to this smooth surface, okay, this polished surface. So there will be no reflected ray. Okay, there will be no reflected ray because there was no vibration direction parallel to this surface. Okay, only that ray passes. So only the refraction will take place. Okay, so this way we get a polarized light. Okay, so and this angle, this Brewster's angle, can be calculated by this formula, which is tan inverse N2, which is the refractive index of the second medium, and divided by N1, which is the refractive index of the first medium. So this was the end of this video, and I hope you learned some new concepts. So if you have any doubts, any questions, you can ask us in the comments. And if you like the video, share it with others also. So see you in my next, the fourth part of this series. Okay, take care guys. Bye bye.